Hi, I'm Sweet Sylvanians and I make videos about Sylvanian families, also known as Calico Critters. Today I'm going to be going through the 2023 UK Sylvanian Families Catalogue to see what's new, and I've also compared it to last year's catalogue to try and work out what might be being discontinued. I got the catalogue when I recently visited the Sylvanian Families shop in London. It's only just been printed, I think Epoch were a bit late doing so, but I'm glad it's out now. So let's first go through the 2023 catalogue. On the front cover, it's a photo of the chocolate rabbit family wearing their newer outfits, among some flowers and the red roof country home in the background. On the first page, we have the contents and a full spread of the new baby mermaid castle. Then there's another overview page. Next is the most recent mystery bag collection, the baby fairy tale series, which came out at the very end of last year. But on the right is the new Baby Seashore Friends series. I've actually made a video all about these when they were announced in Japan, but in summary, I really like them, and I'm now glad that we don't have to wait too long for them to be released here, as it says they'll be available from August. On the next page is a map of the Sylvanian village showing some of the current housing range. Then we get to the families. The chocolate rabbits are up first as usual. And then the newest families, so the fennec foxes, which came out last year, and then the two new families, the Waddle penguins and Snowdrift reindeer. The Waddles were released in March 2022 in Japan, so I feel like I've seen them for ages. I don't own these ones yet, but may buy them when they're out. Epoch have put the wrong photo on for the reindeer, so let's correct that. And the Snowdrift reindeer are lovely. I actually imported the twins from Amazon Japan last year and really like them. On the next page is the revamped periwinkle rabbit family in their new clothes. I really like the pastel floral theme. However, individual baby Henry Periwinkle doesn't feature on this page, so I don't know if he's been discontinued or they've just accidentally missed him out. And the rest of this page contains other newer families with huskies, brightfield goats and high branch giraffes all released last year. There's some more families on the next few pages. These have been out a while, but I'm glad they'll still be around. And even more on the next pages. And the final page of families include two easy buy ones. Moving on to houses, we have the new version of the Red Roof Country Home with Attic. This will be available in the UK later this year, I expect definitely in time for Christmas, and also for this to be the new main home that Epoch advertise. Especially as we have this full page feature on the next page. There's still a couple of cars available, but nothing new there. And then we reach the pastel hues of Amusement Land. Baby Mermaid Castle will be released from August.
Strangely, it is available on the Smith's Toy Shop website right now, so maybe it's an exclusive with them until general release in August.
And we have the new train and Royal Princess sets detailed too. Carrying on with more sets for Amusement Land on the next pages. No new announcements here. Again, nothing new on these family adventure pages, but I like that Epoch are still continuing this range as it feels more traditionally Sylvanian. Which is unlike the Style and Play range. All of these are released already other than the Ponies Vanity Dresser set, which I can't say I'm looking forward to, although the pony figures more generally are growing on me. If I could just buy them individually, I might be tempted. Nothing new on the Fun in the Sun pages, but the Huskies are the focus photo, which is nice. Carrying on is where we find the rest of the fennec fox family and the remaining Waddle penguins. I already own the penguin babies Ride and Play and love it, so I'm glad that it'll be available later in the year without having to get it in from Japan. On the next page is the medical range, and the Village Doctor starter set will be available in August. It features the Persian cat mother Dawn and some pastel hued furniture, and I really like how this can be combined with a car and cosy cottage. The nursery series over the next two pages, but nothing new on these. The baby airplane ride is on the main photo, but not listed, so maybe that might be discontinued too. The triplets baby bath time set featuring the periwinkle rabbit triplets is here and coming out from August, and I think this will be really popular, especially because of the one sleeping triplet that's included. Otherwise, nothing new on these pages. Same goes for the next pages, other than the baby's toy box set. The pieces in this set remind me of some of the Tomy accessories from the early 90s, and I might get this when it comes out, specifically for that crawling panda baby. Nothing new amongst the other furniture, but still features photos of the chocolate rabbits in their old clothes. So I wonder if those will get updated at any point. The fashion playsets is going to be all that remains of the town series, which is a shame as I do like the vibe Epoch we're going for with that range. The new Happy Christmas Friends will be coming out this year, and I particularly love the Snowdrift reindeer in their gingerbread outfit. The Trick or Treat Parade is definitely already out, so I'm not sure why it still has the Available from August label. It might have just not been updated from last year's catalogue. And that's it for the items. The rest is just an advert for their social media and some colouring pages. The rest of the catalogue is other toys from Epoch which aren't Sylvanian families. So now to compare this to last year's catalogue to see which items are no longer listed. This is an indication that they might be discontinued, although I don't have any special knowledge and can't say for definite. And even when items are no longer in production, they'll still be available for a while and on the second-hand market. But with that disclaimer out of the way, let's have a look. Only the newest blind bags are featured, so let's ignore those. And we'll look at houses in a bit, so let's go through families. All of these ones are still in the new catalogue, albeit with newer clothes for the chocolates. All these remain too. And these, again, except for the new outfits for the milk rabbits. But none of the maple cats or chiffon dogs are in the 2023 catalogue, so maybe they're going. And the Springer kangaroo family are also not featured, and Epoch printed the wrong picture for the twins in this catalogue. And the Darwin monkeys on the next page are gone too, so another one to maybe buy soon if you're interested. I did note that the woolly alpacas, both koala families and some others, aren't featured in either catalogue, and they're still available new, so maybe they'll be phased out or just continue to not be advertised. The Red Roof Tower home is definitely not in the new catalogue, so that could be going. And the same with Cedar Terrace. And I guess the old version of the Red Roof Country Home too, but we're just getting an updated version of that. None of the amusement land sets are going anywhere. And I thought I'd show you how these family adventure pages are exactly the same as in the new catalogue. Day at the Seaside set with the farthings is not in the 2023 catalogue. And neither is the farthing cycle with mother set or the canoe set. Those ones have all been out for a number of years, so I guess it makes sense for them to be phased out now. The boutique is listed here, but not in the new catalogue. Along with the majority of these shops, the grocery market I think is the only one which has made it into the new catalogue. Although all the medical sets stick around too. For the nursery series, the school friends and nursery picnic set are gone from the new catalogue. And the carry cases too. I definitely think Epoch are focusing on the blind bags rather than carry cases as their kind of introductory level Sylvanian families. In terms of furniture, the jungle gym and dressing table aren't in the new catalogue. And neither are the bath and shower set, laundry and vacuum cleaner, classic antique bed and classic telephone sets. Neither is the party set and these cooking ones other than the homemade pancake set. And lots of these garden ones are no longer featured either, other than the vegetable garden set. The fashion playsets are still available. All these ones are in the new catalogue. And here's that same Available from August label from last year on the Trick or Treat Parade set, which is in the new catalogue too. So I definitely think that's just a mistake in the 2023 catalogue. And with that, I hope you enjoyed looking through these two catalogues with me. There's lots of new things coming out that I'm excited for, especially those blind bags and the periwinkle rabbit triplets. Are any of these things you've been waiting for international releases of? Let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for watching and subscribe to see new Sylvanian Families videos and news.